I welcome you all to the annual conference on microfinance and savings groups.
According to the Vice President Jessica Alupo, without affordable loans, people cannot start enterprises and opportunities for productive innovations are lost. To ensure increase in access to finances, the government is setting up 10,594 new SACCOs through the parish development model, where affordable loans will be extended to millions of people, including farmers, to help them join commercial agriculture. The Vice President put the development to light today during the opening of the Microfinance and Savings Group Conference 2022 in Kampala.
Offering affordable loans to millions of Ugandans to help them escape subsistence agriculture. The consolidation of various wealth funds into one pot is an important step towards streamlining access to finance. The non-agricultural sectors are covered by the presidential initiative on wealth and job creation.
Government also plans to capitalize the microfinance support center to help achieve its objective of lending to SACCOs and village saving loans associations at competitive rates.
Beyond the household level, there is also access to finance for wholesale lenders. Government and other stakeholders must work together to ensure wholesale lenders in microfinance are well organized, properly capitalized, and able to lend at affordable rates.
The Minister of State for Finance, Haruna Cheyuneka-Solo, advised government not to merge the microfinance institutions with the Ministry of Finance for better supervision.
We request that decision be received so that we can have this industry properly supervised, because we are continuing to give support and a lot of money with the Myoga. It is close to 300 billion shillings extended to those groups. And now PDM every financial year over 8 trillion shillings.
This conference attracted stakeholders in the business profession from various financial institutions across the country.
Where you expect people to start businesses on their own without support from government, you should give them sufficient time to grow, after which you start regulating them. But if you put the regulation before they start the business, then you're killing them.
Protection of the environment, that's the first acronym of ESG. And the second one is the social impact of the people that we give these services to, and thirdly, the governance.
Stakeholders appeal to government not to rush into regulating businesses, especially those that have been started without their support. Report compiled by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.